In this video, I'm going to show you how localization works in UEFN. How you can translate almost everything in your map. Text, billboards, devices, textures, sounds.
Make sure to like and favorite the map if you enjoy it.
Even custom meshes. In the end, you'll know exactly how to set up translations so your players see everything in their own language. So what can actually be localized? Pretty much everything. All Fortnite devices, like for example those ones, an accolade, a message feed device, HD message device, and also a button, everything where you type in text, and of course also billboards. Let's start, right? So here's a billboard, and you can obviously customize it to your needs, but the only important thing right now is this text string right here. Write in everything what we want. For example, this is a test. And right here you can enable or disable if you want this specific billboard to be localized or not. And before we come to the other stuff, let me quickly show you how to localize everything. So go to project, go to project settings. And in here, it is important that you select your native language. I used English as my native language, so obviously I'm gonna select English. Now, you want to select every language you want this to be generated to. In here, you need to choose the languages that you want it to be translated to. I'm gonna choose every language besides my native language. And that's basically it, right? If you have questions about anything right here, then just simply hover over those things and you're gonna get an explanation. Now we can just press the close button, go to build and export localization. You will see you have unsaved changes. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes. Now we will get a message that looks like this. After you got the message, you want to go to build again, and now after you exported the localization, you want to build the auto localization. Now it's finally done, and now after you got this message right here, you want to press import, and now everything is translated. Let's talk about assets. Devices are easy, but what about textures, sounds, or meshes? So now let's take this texture as an example. Go to our file, and this is this texture right here. What you need to do is basically pretty simple. After you created the texture, you need to create other textures in those languages. So this is our texture, how to create a localized file. So it's pretty simple. Just right click on it, go to asset localization, and now create those localized assets. Let's just take Arabic as an example. After we pressed it, nothing happens. Why? Because after we pressed it, you will see now under asset localization, show localized assets, that we get an Arabic one. Now let's do it for every language, and then I'm gonna show you how to add those localized custom files into UEFN. So now you can see that we created all those localized assets, and let's just, for example, click on Arabic, and now we have this texture right here, but it's still in English, and that's what we need to change right now. The easiest way is just to right click on it and re-import this texture with another one. So now let's just choose the Arabic one, and the import is done. And that's basically how easy it can be. Now, how does it work actually? If the player uses, for example, Polish as a language right here and joins my map, he will see those textures in every device in this language. And of course, it's also the same way for all the other languages. If you localize the devices and also localize those textures. This is basically how it's done for anything, but I'm gonna show you an example how it's also done with 3D stuff, which is not even that special, right? It's only this text right here. This is a test, and I also made it in German. So if you click on asset localization, show localized assets, it's German. And when we go to this static mesh right here, you will see it's translated into German. That's a sign test. And this will just override the English version when people have their game in German. Same thing for audio devices. So let's just, for example, go in here and let's just say we have a nice audio, right? You can just right click on it, go to asset localization, and then create localized assets. Let's just, for example, take French version for this, right? So localized file in French. Now what we want to do is show localized assets, French. Now we have this, and now you want to re-import it with a new file. Obviously, I have a file ready to go. So let's launch session and see how it looks like in English and then in some other languages.
Having fun? Follow us for more fun experiences.
So now we launch the session while having the German language selected, and you can see this is just perfect translation. And as the billboard says, right, this part will be translated. This will say English because we disabled the localization of on this one. This one is just a texture. I didn't translate that one. And also the sound right here. You can see it also translated the device.
Wenn dir die Map gefällt, gib ihr ein Like und füge sie zu deinen Favoriten hinzu.
And also the audio got translated. And of course, this billboard as well, and the HD message device as well. And that's basically how it works. You can do it with every language. If you want to access a game-ready pack, make sure to check out our Patreon. All paid newbie members or above will get that for free, and it will get updated from time to time. If you don't want to get the newbie subscription, this is the free tutorial for you. So I personally use ChatGPT, and you can just ask ChatGPT for the translations of whatever you want. And this is an example with the favorite creator. But if you need the voiceovers, you can just head to 11 Labs and type in your voiceovers right here. You can select the voice and pretty simple, add an animation. After that, just press generate speech. Then you will get two different variations, which you can just simply download. And the last step is to convert your MP3 file into a WAV file. Thanks for watching, and make sure to use code UNFABLE in the item shop.